Make it soon. Make it better. Though better never lasts forever. I'll make it small so it fits. Evenness. Even now. Even as the walls come tumbling down. Even as I can't stop remembering how. Every door we ever made, we never once walked out. Something I never got the chance to ask her about. So with flour on my hands, I'll show them all how goddamn happy I am. Sugar, butter, flour, don't let me down. Let's see the next amazing thing baking does now. Hello! How's everyone doing? How's everyone feeling? We're live a little bit earlier today. A couple of reasons. One, I wanted to. Two, I want to rearrange my office. This is like the first time or the last time you'll probably see the office like this. And I was like, well, I need to take apart all my computer stuff to like do that. So I was like, maybe I should, you know, do the stream first. Cause it was either that or no stream. So, but I sat this morning and like planned out what I'm wanting to do on like, website. So like, I'll show you, right. Where is, I need to add an image. I can do that. I can add an image. Add source. Okay, so this is my current office setup, and it's basics without like all the things that aren't meant to be in here. This is my current office, okay? You see we have like my desk at the top, which is where I'm sat right now. You can see my cubby units behind, and then like to the left side, I have a little unit where like my gallery wall is, and then the right side I've got doors. But I'm going to change it so that it looks like this. I'm going to split the room in the middle lengthways, and I'm going to have my office where my gallery wall stuff is at the moment, and like make it a little bit cozier and like put the units to sort of divide the room. And then the other side of those, I can make like a little like cozy nook kind of thing with like a big cuddle chair and big rug on the floor and everything looking cute. So that's my plan. That's what I'm going to attempt to do after stream. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. So for your site view, to be fair, probably won't change too much. It's just that these units will be closer. It's sort of the only thing that I think will be different is the units will now just be closer to the screen. At least for what you see in like this little box. And you also won't see my door anymore, so you'll miss these little random L pop-ups. This is actually the sideboard. I've already put it in the hallway, which is why she's out here. You just hear her little socks, her little feet. Oh, she's going to jump up. There she goes. So, and then my plan is also, I'm going to try and get some like white particle board to like block in a few of these from the side you'll see. So I'll just be like white. And then I'll do the same for the other side. So they all have backs and it means you can kind of see from either side. And then what it also means I can do is like, say I put particle board on like two of these, I then have this space here where I could put like a neon sign that says Smajor, you know, stuff like that. It's going to be a long process of like adding little bits. That's where my brain is. But today we're being a little guardsman. We're going to play this totally adorable game that I see on TikTok and was like, I want to try it, called Little Guardsman. Where you play as a little guardsman deciding whether to let people into the kingdom or not. And it's all voice acted and such. And so it came to pass that the day was to be saved by the most unlikeliest of heroes. A small child unwillingly thrust into the workforce. One disaster after another had been diverted due to the art style. This is adorable. Cunning decision making. With the kingdom on the verge of knowing everlasting peace and prosperity, our hero could finally rest their weary head. That's me. Only after one more it's quiet. Decision was to be made. A decision of great weight. A decision of immense importance. A decision that could possibly kill hundreds, even thousands of people. Oh my God, you've made the wrong choice. You didn't think things through. You've doomed us all. Uh-oh. Everything's on fire now. We're all covered in fire. Not covered in fire. So much just happened. I thought I was a prodigy.
Lil. Lil.
It's great when I don't need to voice act.
What? Oh, Dad, I was... Oh, I must have been having a nightmare.
It's over now, sweetie. But since you're awake, I think it's time you and I had the talk.
Out of one nightmare and into another.
Sweetie, there comes a time in every young person's life...
Well, Dad, you don't have to do this.
When they have to work their dad's shift at the guard shed while he places a bet on the goblin ball match down at the pub.
Aw, Dad, do I have to? Today was the day I was going to start off on a grand adventure with my friends. I want to sail the open sea. I want to fight ogres. I want to throw rocks at things.
You think I didn't want to throw rocks at things when I was your age? But I had a duty. I had a responsibility. I had to work at the guard shed while my dad placed a bet at the goblin ball match down at the pub.
I like the kind of mix of, like, it's like modern but fantasy. So, like, they have like a radio, but then they have posters on the wall, like hanging shelves.
Did he ever win anything?
Do you think we'd be stuck here if he did?
But I'm 12. Won't we get in trouble?
Not if we don't get caught. Come on.
Okay. Teach me how to make this work.
Okie dokie. Ready for me to very quickly show you how everything works?
Yes.
Oh, good. Everyone loves a tutorial.
No time for a full rundown, so I'll sum it up like this. The key thing to remember when being a castle guardsman is...
Dad, someone's coming. What do we do?
Okay. Guess the best way to learn is by doing. Let's just hope there's someone completely plain and boring.
Who is it? Oh, it's old lady.
Ah, good morning, Mrs. Abernathy. How's your day today?
Plain and boring, as always.
Bingo. Would you mind if Lil looks after you?
Oh, not at all. It's always a pleasure to see your daughter, Shamish.
Shamish.
It's Hamish.
Hamish.
What is?
Never mind. Now, Lil, when a visitor approaches the guard shed, they'll generally start by stating their business.
I will say, why did you name your child Lil? Is it Lilith?
I'd like to state my business. I bring a basket of baked goods to my son and his family once a week. Oh, would you like one?
Have a cinnamon roll. You can go in, bestie.
After they state their business, it's pretty much your... You can select them and interrogate them. There's tools, the phone there on the wall. You only get 3 action points. Okay. You get it, right?
Yeah.
Not really. What do we need tools for?
You can pick one and it does something. Come on, Lil. I've really got to speed this along. The goblin...
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm inconveniencing you?
Oh, no, not at all, dear. I don't mind helping out.
But the princess is whirligigging the ceremonial for a slingshot.
She is? Sweet jumping jitters, we gotta get to that game. Let's wrap this up, dear. Seamus, tell the girl what jitters. To do.
Azrael Symmetry, or System. Thank you so much, part of the frame sub. Don't know why I said symmetry.
The name is Hamish.
No, it's Mrs. Abernathy.
Click a highlighted area to learn about it.
I already told you. Select...
Okay.
Sometimes.
Sometimes using a tool will do the job better, or the phone, or it's a combination of things. I don't know.
What's the bag?
Didn't we cover this?
My inventory.
That's looking in your bag for something to use.
Okay,
doesn't cost.
I don't appreciate the passive aggressiveness tone that I'm getting from my father here. This is my first day in the job. I'm 12. This is the Royal Writ, the first thing to look at when you start a shift to take a look. Confirmation you need to do for your job. You can select Royal Writ anytime and it won't cost any action points. Ah. The Castle Guard Corp can achieve a good star rating this month will be pizza party. The desk councilwoman Ash, this will be a demonstration as a square this evening held. Members of the Guild Mages of Enspears come through your gate. Please call my office to initiate their escort and secondary screening. Okay, so if anyone says they're part of the Mages Guild, we need to call. Congratulations to Guardsman Randy on 35 years at his post. Okay, Randy. After 6 months undercover operation the Spawn Cavern for the elderly, a group of sweet grannies and grandpies are discovered to be traveling illegal drugs in and out of the city. Not every old person is on the is to be treated like a drug mule. Please be vigilant when dealing with somebody's grandparent. Is this an edible cinnamon roll? Is she giving me the baked goods?
Feeling stuck? This phone is for calling the royal advisors and asking for their help. You can get a hold of Lieutenant Stryker, Captain of the Guards, and technically our...
Hello, who's there?
Or First Councilwoman Ash, the head bureaucrat of the...
This is Councilwoman Ash. Hello.
And finally, the royal jester Malcolm, chaos personified in human...
Hello, you've reached Malcolm. Please leave a message after the goose honk. Hey, where'd the goose go?
Each call costs an action point.
Okay.
Oh. Our tools. If you want to use a tool, you have to make sure it has a crystal to charge it. Here, I'll show you. I'll add today's crystals to the tools that don't have any. That way, I have a well-rounded arsenal.
Why do the other tools already have crystals in them?
I carry them over from previous days. Any other questions?
Why does a bullwhip need to be powered by crystals?
No more questions.
Okay.
You use the Wicked 3000 to make the big decision to let someone in. Now, you can choose to use the Wicked 3000 at any point during a turn, but sometimes it's better to use up all three action points to find out everything.
Sometimes?
Yeah. And sometimes people are in a really big hurry, like I am right now.
I'm gonna pill it, because Ronnie, you have a great time. You have fun.
Great job, little. Your mother would be so proud to see you now.
No, that's not.
After my delivery, I'm off to watch the big game. Got my grandson's inheritance riding on a tip that the Stapleford Snughorns are gonna win it today.
Here's a tip. Never lend Mrs. Abernathy money to bet with.
Let's hurry along to the game. We don't want to be late, do we, Hamish?
Remind you of Papers, Please. Yeah, it's Papers, Please, but in like a fantasy setting.
My name is Shamish. No, wait, it's not. Oh, I better go. Time to put on your big kid pants. You can do this.
More like I'm being forced to do this.
It's only for today, oh, nice. I swear. Come meet me in the tavern when the shift is over. Good luck.
Good luck with your illegal gambling.
I don't need luck.
Believe me, he does.
I love
okay,
the grandma.
Well, you...
Okay, guys, we're ready. Nailed tutorial, good job. Okay, so I've already read that. I know now to be aware of other old people. Thank you, thanks for the 217. Oh.
Charmed to make your acquaintance, young gateminder. I am Tyronius Athanatos, son of Brielle and Darunia Athanatos.
I don't know who that is.
I have been summoned to deliver the keynote speech at the Festival of Magical Freedom tonight, hosted by the Mages Guild.
Oh, I have to call.
Will you require anything further?
I need to call. Ash. Like, hi, bestie.
I'm so glad you called. Frankly, I was worried you guardsmen never followed the writ due to illiteracy. Admit the mage and my people will escort him to the venue.
Yes. How do I know he's actually him, though?
What's your speech about?
Oh, my dear child. It is obvious to me that you do not possess a magical bone in your body, and my speech, therefore, would only serve to confuse and frighten you.
The only one confused is you, about how frightened you are of me, stupid. Man, I really need to work on my...
I admire your bravery, but you walk a fine line between bravery and foolishness. Be warned.
I'm gonna talk one more time.
So what's this? The Festival of Magical...
Tonight hundreds, maybe thousands, of like-minded mages, shamans, witches, wizards, and warlocks will gather to express our rights to use our gods-given talents without having to bend our knee to the preposterous laws of lesser beings.
Ah.
Lesser beings like me?
Precisely.
So it's a quote-unquote festival to have the freedom to use your magic whenever and however you want?
A being like you could never understand.
I don't know. Sounds to me like you are already pretty free.
I guess I'm gonna admit him. Although he looks creepy, I can't judge it based off of just a man being born like that, you know? Like, he's a snob.
The House of Thanatos, and indeed the entire Mages Guild, thank you, young guardian. You will go far.
It's not, like, read the right and followed orders. Good little guardsman. Thank you. Oh my goodness, is this game gonna praise me every time I do a good job? Oh!
Good afternoon. I am here to pick up my two kids from the no-good, stingy, low-life of a father who happens to be my lying, cheating, low-life of an ex-husband, Orlando.
First,
his address is there on
Orlando.
This incomprehensible, illegible letter my kids sent me. Believe me, I would love to have him get off his sorry butt and bring them to me for once.
You know, I kind of love her.
It was his week with them. No, I'm sorry. It was his and his new girlfriend Callie's week with them.
Not
and
the new girlfriend already?
And you
want to
know what the kids say about her?
What?
They say she's fun.
Fun?
I'm sure the letter they wrote is all about her. Can't decode it to save my life, though. My kid's writing is so lousy.
I trust that.
That letter was pretty much illegible.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
Horrible, horrible penmanship.
Exactly. They need talk.
Kelly really hit it off with our children, Polyphemus and Orlando Jr. She's got a lot of energy and gives us special treats.
That's nice. But what district are you going to?
What district? I told you. The address is on that letter I showed you. It's the only thing written that's legible. You'd need a decoding spell or something to read the actual letter. I love my kid.
I kind of want to just trust her. I will not lie. Like, I feel like the amount of detail she's given me, I'm like, you go, bestie. Get your kids. Hit that man. You know?
You might want to get your kids some after-school help so they can practice their penmanship.
Right now, I just want to make sure their father's new apartment with Kelly isn't a flea-infested rat's nest in a terrible part of town.
That's fair. I'm gonna let her in. You did great. Hide your kids.
Thanks! Don't worry, Polyphemus!
Good luck.
I have a decoding ring. Send it to your mom bear and her cub. See? 3 stars. I just wanted the tea. That was the only reason I kept talking. Oh no.
What in the bloody blazing blasted hell is the holdup? Why have we stopped, Welp?
Well, sir, the guard.
That's me.
Silence! Speak when spoken to or you'll get the whip. Well,
you did ask.
Yes, sir.
Now, you, child, let me pass. I have important business to attend to. Come on, shake a leg. B.S. waits for no...
B.S.?
Bank of the Sprawl.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Wait, so what did it say about the bank? First Joker seeks person with funny name. Fresh Joker seeks person with funny name, B.S.? There's a cash bonus in it for you. I need to call Malcolm. Malcolm, do I have a name for you?
Didn't you know the louder you are, the more important you are? That's why I'm so powerful! Let my loud, bossy, jackass friend through!
I just thought his name was funny.
What kind of business do you have at the bank today, sir?
I shan't be airing the details of my BS appointment with some nosy little brat tending the gate. Mind your business or you'll get the...
Oh, you want to see... I can turn to white people, actually. I'm going to tease him.
Oh, yes. We mustn't... BS is right.
You're getting whipped 100%, dude. As soon as you threatened the whip, you were done.
I'm sorry, sir. I was just slouching, only for a second. I'll make sure that none of the blood gold falls out of its case.
You nincompoop! It wasn't me using the whip. If it was, believe me, you'd feel it.
Blood gold.
Wait a second. Did he say blood gold? Isn't that illegal?
He didn't say blood gold, he said bloody gold. It's a form of slang he must have picked up from somewhere. Isn't that right, you bloody idiot?
Yes, sir. Whatever you say, sir.
I'd like to take a closer look at those gold bars. I think I need to hold on to these.
Why, you greedy little urchin. I think I like you more than ever.
No, it's not like that.
Oh, of course. Just remember, if you make any form of profit off of those, you're as much to blame as I am.
Okay, so I'm just gonna
look. Now, since you are finished rifling through my personal belongings, you insuffer.
Do I let him through? Or do I jail him? Well, Malcolm told me I have to let him through. I can't jail. I can just deny entry or admit. I can't jail him, guys. I don't have the ability to. My thought is, like, if I say no, he's gonna beat the goblin. And I've already taken the blood. Okay, we'll deny.
It's the goblin's fault, isn't it? Nasty, deceptive creatures. What about this? Let me through the gate, but I shall leave the goblin tied up outside like the cur he is.
But sir, the gold!
Silence! All right, you rotten little girl, I'll go. But you will ruin...
Oh, we don't like him. Saw the blood gold trafficker on the first day? Damn, okay! We're really good at this. It's gonna throw me when it has someone be really nice to me, and then it turns out they're bad. Oh, hello.
Good afternoon. This is Dr. Marquess Beatrix von Matterhorn calling. Who may I ask am I speaking to?
This is Lil.
Nice to meet you, Lil. I need one of you gate guards to come down to the dig site as soon as you can.
Okay.
Okay, and where exactly is... She hung up.
That's not my job. Hi.
Why, hello there. I have come to the Sprawl to participate in capitalism.
Love that.
After years on the road as a traveling merchant, I'm finally ready to put down roots. And what better place than the sprawling metropolis of the Sprawl?
Exactly.
Huh. I just got that. Garby Bunches is the name.
Garby Bunches? funny name. But that's gotta be made up. I'm gonna have to see some document.
Can't fault you for doing your due diligence. Here's my vendor's license, issued by the Spro-
Funny name. Yeah, that looks... Sure, I'll return it.
He's right. Everything is in order.
I should call Malcolm to be like, hey, I've got a funny name, guy.
Garvey Bunches. Where have I heard that name before? Wait a minute. Ask him if he's descended from Garbanzo the Terrible.
Are you related to Garbanzo the Terrible?
Yep. My great-great-great-great-grandpappy Garbanzo.
OMG, tell him I'm a huge fan. I've got so many questions. Like, why did he use an ice cream scoop? How did he dispose of all that mess?
This isn't helpful.
You're not helpful!
Okay. We tried Truth Spray. I just think he's just legit.
I just can't wait to get in the mix and figure out what kind of merchant this place really needs. Since I was a boy selling lemonade, when life literally gave me lemons, I've dreamed of maximizing profits and keeping overhead low.
Seems like a weird dream for a kid to have.
You couldn't possibly understand, little girl, with your cushy government job. Wait, shouldn't you be in school or off playing or something?
Don't ask.
See, you get it. Once I've set up shop selling, well, whatever I decide to sell, I'll be sure to give you a discount.
I look forward to buying...
And we're gonna do Truth Spray.
Nice try, kid. As a merchant on the road, I spent the last few years building up a tolerance to the active ingredient in Truth Spray.
Well, that's unexpected.
You know what they say. Never go in against a Sicilian when death is on the line.
Inconceivable.
I should have X-rayed him. I'm gonna say no.
Come on, my paperwork checks out. I'm a good guy.
Deny. Sorry.
I'll be back. This isn't the...
Okay, Garvey Bunchies. I got a two. We're going against this sweet, humble merchant. He's harmless. I don't trust it. I don't trust it. I do not trust it. Almost built. Almost built. Oh, see, him I got four. I only got three. Or I got four for her. So I missed something with those two. I don't care. I'm not, like, trying to min-max this. I think I should have, like, X-rayed him. Or metal detectored him. The dig site? I guess that's where I'm going. To see what the other person wants. It's like papers, please, but nicer, yeah. Hello.
Oh my, were you left behind? The last group of school children departed hours ago. Feel free to wait in the lost and found box until someone comes to collect you.
No, you called me. I'm Lil. We spoke on the phone. I was covering for my dad at the South Gate.
Of course, Lil. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. But no, this is highly irregular. But then again, you'll have to do. For the sake of time. Ha! Sake of time. Do you get it?
Okay. No.
No.
Trust me, you will.
Who are you again?
Dr. Marquess Beatrix von Matterhorn, head of archaeological research at the Royal Academy. But you can call me B.
Gotcha. And what's so great about this place?
Would you like the long or short version?
Short and sweet.
It's a hole in the ground where we get power crystals from.
Okay.
That was short. Sweet.
What's this got to
do with me? The preeminent expert in the advanced properties of power crystals, and my research suggests we have barely scratched the surface of what these puppies can do.
Things. Okay, but again, what does this have to do with me?
Lil, I have found how to harness the crystal's power to alter the very fabric of time. May I present the chronometer 3000?
Okay.
And what I need to know from you is, do you know anyone who would be willing to go on what some might call an adventure?
Yes.
Oh, me! I want to go on an adventure!
Wonderful. But before you go off and start pushing buttons willy-nilly, let me explain how I came across this incredible new discovery. Or more... You see, by transmuting the crystal's more raw and ethereal properties and tethering it to a gnomish astrolab, they can produce temporal anomalies.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We began experimenting by fashioning teeny tiny harnesses and attaching the crystals to mice and directing radio signals towards them.
Okay.
We perfected the process and found that we could send these mice back minutes, hours, even a full day with a less than 13% fatality.
Just do it. I'm going to just push the button. Oh. Wait, have I gone back in time?
Wait, what? Where am I?
I got the phone.
Good afternoon. This is Dr. Marquess Beatrix von Matterhorn calling. Who may...
Check this out. You were about to tell me you need a gate guard to come down to the dig site, right?
My word, you gate guards are intuitive. I hope they're paying you a more than fair wage.
They probably aren't, the way my dad complains about it. She hung up. Again.
Why, hello there. I've come to the...
Let me stop you there. Your name is Grabby Blanchers, right? You're a traveling merchant or something?
Oh, I see my reputation precedes me. Kinda.
This is so weird. I swear I already dealt with this guy. I can either do the same thing as I did last time, or maybe this is a chance...
I'm sorry, are you talking...
That's what I'm trying to decide.
Regardless, here's my vendor...
I'm gonna confiscate it for now.
Oh, I think I might need...
I think I'm gonna need it more.
Okay, if you say...
I need to get this guy processed and get my butt back to the...
Okay, now we try... Do I deny or admit him this time? Do I deny or admit him? I can't go back, I can't do anything. I can't scan, it's not letting me, it makes me pick one. Guys, I can't scan him. I just have to pick one. More people are saying admit. Let's admit him this time. I've got his papers. We'll see what happens.
I swear I've been through this once already. Did I just tug at the fabric of space and time? Okay, this
Aiden,
is way
so
above
for
my
the
pay grade.
Tier 1 sip for 21 months.
Can you smell that?
The trash barge? Yeah, it comes through on the weekends. The smell only lingers for a couple of days.
Not the reek of filth and decay. That's the reek of opportunity.
I need to get back to the dig site to figure out what just happened.
Hello.
Oh, Lil, from the phone call earlier, of course. Yeah.
I already told you no.
My name is Dr.
Mological Research at the Royalty School for Smart People. You said I can call you Trixie. We've been through this, but
I'd prefer if you called me B.
And this is the site where power crystals were first discovered and you used them to make a time machine. Then you baited me with promises of adventure and pretty much forced me to push the big shiny button on your silly little time machine, and now I'm pretty sure I'm just traveled back through time and I'm kind of freaking out here! Any questions?
Wait, why am I asking you questions? For any of this to be possible, it would require the use of my newly...
You just did that.
Wait, where did it go?
Do you mean this?
My invention! How did you get that?
You gave it to me. Well, not really, but you were gonna give it to me,
And you were seduced by the glowing red button.
Yeah.
Can you blame me?
Yes, but it is a good button. I'm just proud of myself that your particles weren't immediately dispersed to the furthest reaches of space and time.
Mm-hmm.
That risk becomes much lower once I configure it to your individual life source, which I will do now.
Thank you.
At any rate, I think the castle gate is a perfect place to test my prototype, and I need a willing gate guard to use the device. And allow me to track their progress to make sure only the right people are permitted entry to the sprawl. Do you have any questions?
Right
people?
Individuals or groups that would improve the daily life of the inhabitants of the sprawl, rather than those who would see harm come to the community and castle.
Okay.
Isn't that subjective?
Yes, well, I suppose it is, but recently the kingdom has seen a rise in rebellious factions, envious neighboring nations, not to mention the resentful mages guild since the power crystal has replaced most household magical applications. One wrong choice could trigger a domino effect that could lead to the fall of the sprawl.
That's a lot of pressure to put on me, and I'm only 12.
I think I get the idea, Dr. B. I'm ready to go out in the world and use this device properly, and definitely not to win the lottery or to repeatedly watch people trip and fall over and over.
You'd want that?
With all that money, I could pay people to trip and fall over and over.
Regardless, you'll find you can't use it whenever or wherever you want. It is now calibrated, so it will only allow you to fold space and time when you are inside the guard shed.
Oh.
Ah, rats.
Furthermore, by default, the device will automatically allow you to travel back to the start of your guard shift, including your loadout. However, I've hacked it a bit so that you can jump back to a specific point in the turn. Okay. Hack is the key word, though. I have to leave now. There is more science to be done.
Okay.
I will summon you soon, and we will see what else you might be ready for. Thank you, Lil.
No pressure.
You can do this. Just...
Okay, let me...
I'm not kidding.
No.
Maybe I should have mentioned I was only working the gate for one day. It's getting pretty late. I should head home.
Okay, I head home now. Here's my house. You live at the tavern? Do you just have a permanent room, or...? Let's just at least see her father before heading up. Doesn't really have anywhere else to be, okay. Where's dad? There he is. Yeah.
Hey, hey, there she is! My hard-working angel face, sweetest of the sweetest.
You didn't win your gambling, did you?
No, but it wasn't my fault. The other team was just too good. But I didn't lose all my money. We still have left what I didn't bet, so...
What's the mean?
That'll be 15 gold for the ale.
And now we don't have any left. Hey, Lil, did you take any bribes or pickpocket any...
Oh. No, I didn't. I don't want to give him the money.
Sorry, nothing today.
Oh, rats.
Rats? Again? I mean, we don't have rats, I swear.
No, not like that. Well. I'll go call my guy anyways. See if...
Wait, you'll never believe what happened. Right at the end of my shift, I got this phone call, okay? Asking me to come down to the dig site.
Did you remember to lock up the shed?
What? Yes.
And turn off the light?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I did. Whatever, just listen.
You gotta make sure to turn off the light, Lil. They'll charge us for the overnight use.
I remember to turn off the light. I think. Anyways, Dad, I met this professor at the dig site, and she had this time machine, and when I touched the time machine, I went back in time. Then she gave me the time machine to use when I worked the guard shed for you, but it only works at the guard shed, so that was kind of a bummer. But it's super cool, and it only works for me.
That's great, sweetie. I'm glad you liked covering for me today. But you don't have to make up stories just so you can work another shift.
Wait, no, that's not what's happening.
Anytime you want to be just like Daddy and work to...
Dad, you're not fully comprehending what I'm trying to tell you.
Hey, Arda, did you hear? Lil's making up cute stories so she can be more...
Oh, that's so sweet.
I'm going to click through the quickly, guys.
Okay.
This isn't...
I want to get into...
Speaking...
Good night, Dad.
I don't need...
I want to sleep. So I can start next day.
Whew!
On the way to the bar, Miss Harmony suddenly walked into two more tutorials, causing her to be delayed for the medical game. Her grandson's inheritance is safe for now. Tyronius gave his keynote speech at the Festival of Magic Freedoms, inspired most of the crowd. The divide between magical and non-magical begin beings grew a little more than Uh-oh. He's indebted to Councilwoman Ash for influence in facilitating the smooth demise to sprawl. Denise retrieved her children from her bum of an ex-husband Orlando. She said hello to Kelly, but never looked at her. Once the kids were out of the way, Miss Orlando Senior took Kelly out to dinner at the Monty's restaurant, home of the soup. They took advantage of full budget of Kelly's employee discount. Due to your cunning confiscation and denying the old coot, Rumpkin T. Dankworth was unable to make his sizable deposit of illegal blood to BS. Conversion happened on the same day of an unprecedented amount of cash withdrawals. This caused the bank to run and close early. People panicked, they burned the bank down to the ground. They would refuse to donate money to have it rebuilt. We just found a vacant plot of land behind it was set up as an Emporium of Wonders. Well, I suppose full marks. All they did was set up a shop. I'm okay with that so far. I have no quarrels there.
Good morning. You're listening to The Morning Crawl, the number one morning show in the spring. I'm your host, Dodger, joined as always by my co-host, The Ham, who I will remind you is a live pig. Let's jump right in and get your
It
was just announced that the heir to the throne, Princess Desdemona, has come of age and will be taking a suitor.
Ooh.
No, I don't think Desdemona wants a pig.
Okay, we're gonna...
I liked it better when it was Dodger and the Cluck. But I guess it was too hard to keep training that chicken.
Okay.
A note?
What does that say?
Maybe he wants me to work a shift for him again.
Or,
well, there's a 50-50 chance I'll get to use the...
Okay. Can't believe the bank got burnt down.
And finally, the aforementioned grading pending review will be transferable, which is, needless to say, a more economical contrivance for evaluation.
Many questions.
Hey, Dad, I got your note. What's going on?
I have no idea.
Due to the Bank of the Sprawl being burned to the ground as a result of your actions, any guardsman who does not receive an above 2-star rating at the end of any given shift will lose their job.
But I need my job for gambling.
I'll pretend I didn't just hear that.
You and I both know my dad has a tendency to half-ass his way through life. Tell me why he needs to whole-ass it all of a sudden and strive for anything above 2-star.
Why, I'm glad you asked. I've been authorized to award above average job performance with cash bonuses.
Ooh. You mean if we get more 4-star results, we'll make more money?
You're as quick as your father. Before I go, here are the allotted crystals to power your tool. And with that, I'm off to tell all the other gate guards about these new rules.
Not Randy! That guy's a riot!
Which is exactly what his poor judgment led to. Wish.
Okay.
Aw, jeez. Randy was just 3 payments away from paying off his new catapult.
Sounds like you need to start doing your job better.
More like you need to start doing my job better. Just like you want.
No, that's not exactly what I meant. You don't just get to leave me here while you go bet on goblin ball games.
No goblin ball match today. I received a cryptic letter this morning saying they need me on palace duty, and they specifically reference that you need to cover for me again. Looks like you're not the only one who wants you to work the gate today.
Again, not what I meant.
It's not all bad news. I scored these off-brand discount crystals from my bookie Fredo as a gift for being his best, but he mentioned that they might only work some of the time. But I like those off.
Oh, I've got like fake crystals.
Oh, Dad, you really need to talk.
I love you too, Lil. And with that, I'm...
No pressure.
That's my girl.
Between not getting her dad fired and also... Okay, so Malcolm. Rather than repairing the dungeon, which is falling apart, leading to the escape of serial arsonist, I'm having the jail cells painted instead. Give me a call when the fellow gets here. So if there's a painter here, call Malcolm. Fled the imminent arrival of 2 envoys vying for an alliance with the Sprawl. It's 2 envoys, not 3, but 2. 4 is right out. Today's opportunity for cultural exchange, learn as much as you can, really get them talking. Duchess of Scarborough's award, winning feline companion Sprinkles, shall be arriving in his miniature royal carriage this week. As always, treat any non-human visitor, goblin, gnome, and ogre with extra scrutiny. Remember, if you see something, say something. Okay, well that's racist. So, just throw it out there. The last ogre lady wasn't her fault. Why did none of them have crystals? Or do I give them crystals? Do I click on them? Oh, I do. Okay, I'll give you a normal crystal. I'm gonna give you a fake one, because I don't know if I'm gonna need a decoder. Same as I want to give you one. You can have this fake one. Okay, I think I'm ready. Okay. Hello!
Hello, ma'am. The name is Seamus McGoblin. I've been requested to do some work in the Sprawl. Just have my supplies here with me. Nothing else to declare.
Where in the Sprawl?
You have paint with you. Are you like an artist?
Me? An artist? No, ma'am. I have a real job. I'm a painter. I paint things like walls and doors. An artist? Oh, you're giving me a laugh.
You may laugh, but I'm sure that you're an artist at heart.
I'll have to tell Mrs. McGoblin that.
Mrs. McGoblin?
If I'm being honest, I'm not sure what I'm being asked to paint. A note was left at my
Oh, you passed me. I've got some work for you to do. Come to the Sprawl at 2:30. There are 2 ways to paint your stuffs, one legit, the other in cuffs. I've got ways that you can earn your portion of Sprawl currency. Paint your stuffs, one legit, the other in cuffs. You have to call that guy.
Mysterious letters are way more common these days, and I have a feeling I'm the little girl they're talking about.
I didn't want to say, but you are.
For my age, I'm not.
How old are you?
I'm 12.
You still seem pretty little.
Yeah, I'm gonna call Malcolm. Hello, Malcolm.
Well, it's about time he showed up. Send him to my office toot suite and I'll set him to work. No more doom and gloom. What's that? Yes, I insist the horse get into the water. This is water polo after...
You can go in. You enjoy. You're painting some jail cells.
Many thanks. Say, before I go, do you have a favorite color?
Green.
I like green, I guess.
Then I shall paint whatever it is I'm painting green in your honor.
Aww.
Thank you again.
I hope Malcolm likes green. Time to his job, or do you want a parade? Yes, actually. I would like a parade. Oh.
Hear ye, hear ye. I have come to announce to the princess a proposal of marriage from my lord and master, Prince Phineas Pomp, heir to the throne of Petrad.
Oh.
Prince Phineas, son of King Phineas and Queen Buttermilk, who was daughter of King Fangil, son of Queen Amelia, son of Queen Anne.
Thank you. Wow, okay.
Two envoys.
Prince Phineas himself will arrive in the sprawl after a ceremonial visit to the Royal Sulphur Mines of Petrad. The prince will be christening the newest of our sulfuric refineries by smashing a bottle of Petradian fizzy over the front door.
I guess you weren't important enough to go to the big party, huh?
As a matter of fact, the prince assured me it was much more important that I travel all the way here to announce his eventual arrival.
And you bought that?
I did, until just this moment. An alliance between the great kingdom of Petrad and the Sprawl would benefit both sides mightily. Imagine the petrol and gunpowder our sulfur mines produce, combined with the technological advancements that your power crystals produce.
Has Princess Desdemona ever even met Prince Flinflon?
Phineas. Prince Phineas.
Please, stop!
I suppose I could call. I can call Ash. Be like, hi. You know anything about this man?
Oh, they're starting to arrive. How wonderful. This is the representative of Prince Phineas Pomp, son of King Phineas and Queen...
Buttermilk.
None for me, thanks. Anyway, let them in. But for the love of... Don't let them in with that bugle. Not until I've gotten over this dreadful hangover, at least.
I claim the...
Can I see that trumpet?
That is my official Petradian greeting bugle.
I think for the sanity... I mean safety.
Oh, if you must, but...
Be very careful with my prayer. I can go next for the cinnamon roll. We're supposed to be two, yeah, but they're not going to come at the same time, Laurie. They're different kingdoms trying to marry the same person. They're going to come together.
Onward to announce the eventual arrival. Okay, if you refuse her entry, I will give you much gold tonight. I will meet you at the tavern after your shift. Remember, do not let in the Marvog delegate.
You can't... He's trying to bribe me. He's a high-ranking visiting dignitary and took his bugle away. He was terrible, so he does baseball deserves. Good job. You're asking me to choose you over a woman. That's really hard. Oh, hello.
Good afternoon, child. I would like to enter this bustling metropolis with the desire to purchase a hat. I have lost my previous hat and I require a replacement.
Okay.
Why come all this way to buy a hat? Surely they have hats where you're from.
They do, yes. But they do not match the standards of my previous hat. I was known well as one who adorned a hat of the highest caliber. I cannot go back.
Maybe you haven't looked hard enough?
I promise, child. I have searched high and low for the perfect hat. This sprawl is my last hope.
Okay. Is there anything on here about a hat? No, something about a cat. Any non-human villager. Two envoys was awaiting in one. And then that's the painter, so... Just for waiting on another envoy. This has nothing to do with anything I'm warned about.
This old hat of yours must have been something special.
Oh, it was. It was the most fantastic hat you had ever seen.
Like, trust him.
That is how I acquired my name. Signor Capello Fantastico.
What does that mean?
Mr. Fantastic Hat.
That's a very fitting name.
Alas, it was. My good name.
You know, I'm gonna let him in. But if this is the lie you've chosen to come up with to break into here when you're not meant to be, deserved. You find a hat. There's a Wonder Emporium round the corner.
I hope you find your hat, Mr. Fantastico.
Thank you, child. The next time you see me, you will say to yourself, wow, has that guy got a fantastic new...
I have no doubt in my mind.
Goodbye. Hey, there are no obstacles for him to chase his dreams. He'd tip his hat for the gratitude if he had one. Good luck, Mr. Fantastico. Enjoy. Oh.
I come with a message for Princess Desdemona of the Sprawl from Praetor Kargan of the Marvag Empire.
Oh, this is the one I was meant to block.
The Praetor bid me say directly to the Princess, Egtag Maya Kora Una Guahatag. Grant me access to deliver this message personally, and I shall recite the Praetor's words to the Princess with honor. Hail, Praetor Gargan! Kapla! I killed 19 other mighty adversaries for the honor of delivering this message to your Princess.
Okay.
I have brought you the head of the mightiest of these for you to inspect, as is our custom.
Oh.
Oh my god! This is how you know I am worthy to deliver.
I just have a head. I'm gonna look in it. Yeah, it was just a severed head. Okay. And love her icon.
The Praetor is attending the ballet tonight. Upon its completion, Praetor Car.
Oh, so the Praetor's coming here later tonight?
Not likely. In Marvog, the ballet can last days, weeks even. It continues until only one dancer survives. Ballet is one of the finest blood sports in the Marvog Empire, and the bodies of fallen ballerinas are stacked high in the main square, as is our custom.
Doesn't the giant pile of dead ballerinas, kind of stink?
Ha ha! Indeed it does! This stink is a constant reminder of the danger and sacrifice made by the noble. You see, the slaughtered dozens of...
What'd you call it? I'm gonna call the woman again. Just to make sure. I'm gonna call Ash and be like, hey, Ash. Bitch lady.
The mighty Empire of Marvog has sent an envoy from the Praetor. This is unfolding even more splendidly than I imagined. And what an envoy. All that leather. I'm sorry, what did you say?
I literally have not said a word.
Oh, well, woo! Please show her in and don't interfere. Leave her just the way she is.
Ooh. She's also kind of free. An eagle, big lady. You have fun.
You have honor, little one, and shall always be a friend of the Marvag. And now, to fulfill my mission to speak the Praetor's words to the Princess.
You enjoy. You met extremely well-armed visiting dignitary. Smart. Yeah, that's true. Could have killed me. Oh.
Whoa there, Lucy. Hello and salutations to you, most honorable guardian of the free peoples of the... I am the envoy of the gallant Sir Beverly, a knight of some minor renown, which is also me. I have received a very special invitation from Her Majesty Princess Desdemona. If there's nothing else, I...
Yeah, there's people in that horse.
What's with the horse?
My noble steed, Lucy?
I don't know how to say this, but that horse is two people in a costume. How?
We told you this wouldn't work. Can we get our $10 now?
Have you ever met Princess?
Alackaday, I have not. 'Tis but a glimpse of her I have yet beheld, but that image has drawn me here like a... And, though it is true I have never known the caress of a lover, the thought of it fills my loins to bursting.
It's just some weird, like, Reddit user.
How do you know she wants you to come and marry her if she's never met you before?
In that glimpse of her, I could see she was longing for...
Yeah... I don't...
I'm just gonna block that button. There we go. Buy that. The kind of person that's like... His wife and the girl...
I understand. You are being controlled by powerful forces and simply following orders. But know this.
There is
no force more powerful...
Please react to the rejection.
...than love.
Kind of a green flag. Like, actually, you know, that's actually kind of like green flag.
You have not seen the last of Beverly, late night custodian of the Goblin Ball Stadium. On, Lucy.
Shut up, Beverly.
The fact that he wasn't like, I'm gonna get you. But the fact that he was like, that's fine, you're just doing your job. Like, well, it's a green flag, isn't it? He's not getting mad at the server. It's like people who get mad
hey
at servers and restaurants.
Hey kid, are you Lil?
They're just working. My Lil? Who's asked?
Show a bit of respect. If you see her, tell her I got a mysterious letter.
Mysterious, you say? Fine, you've got me. Who's it from?
I'm not authorized to know.
That is mysterious. Does this mysterious letter have anything to do with the one my dad Hamish got this morning?
Your dad is Hamish? What a good guy. Did you hear about Randy, though?
Yeah. Only 3 payments away on that catapult.
Yeah, it's a real shame. Anyways, just take the note. I gotta get back to work.
Okay. Thanks.
See you around, kid.
Little girl stands at a gate, making choices I can't wait. If you've got taste of madness and wish to circumvent great sadness, come and meet me after dark. Together we make our stamp in the world. This is from Malcolm, Dungeon 7, Room 4.
Nothing weird or creepy about that.
Weird. Why is he trying to meet up with a 12-year-old?
Where's that music coming from? What is happening?
I've traveled from afar, a simple girl who wished upon a star. Inside this castle lies my fate, perhaps I'll even get a date. To my old life I sing au revoir.
And you are? It's Lil, and you need a good reason to be let in, but so far I'm not optimistic. Do you have any ID or anything?
I assure you that my heart is true. Must this be a whole to-do? Inside these walls, my destiny awaits.
Wish you could sing.
It just feels like if you weren't singing, we could move the plot along faster.
I'm just so, so thrilled to finally be here in the sprawl. The people, the culture, the food, the hundreds of dark alleyways that could just swallow a person up. I have to say, I'm losing patience, Lil. At first you seemed so innocent, but still.
My baby's
I have
trench.
A hunger driving me, the people everywhere will see. My dark destiny I will fulfill.
That took a dark turn.
Striker, hiya bud, you got a sword icon.
For the love of what is that?
Excuse me, who are you talking to? What are you saying to them? Are you talking about me? Behind my back?
I'm right in front of you.
No, it drives me crazy when people talk about me behind my back right in front of me. This is making me angry.
Oh, maybe let's try singing? At times like this, what helps is this, calming down.
This isn't a duet. I'm the star here. You think you're going to burn me? It's me that's going to burn you.
This was that kind of game.
I keep on retrying.
Where's that music coming from? What is happening?
Good afternoon. I've traveled from afar. A simple girl who wished upon a star. Inside this castle lies my fate. Perhaps I'll even get a date. To my old life I sing au revoir.
I mean, she kind of slaps here, though, even though I know she murders me.
And you are?
It's Lil, and you need a good... Do you have any ID or anything?
I assure you that my heart skip is
it.
True.
Must this... It does slap, but I can skip. Okay, I think... I want to do truth spray to see if she sings truthfully.
I lie awake at night worried that my parents are right. I should have become a lawyer or a doctor, and I'll never make it in theater. Oh. Also, I've got a rap sheet as long as my arm, and I'm wanted in 7 counties. So there's that.
Why, that was so strange. I seem to have blacked out for a moment. No matter.
You're the worst.
At least she didn't throw a Molotov cocktail at me this time. You know? Apparently, homicidal media can turn her away with right till there might have been more to find. Do we try again? I kind of want to try again. I'm doing it. I'm going back to her. Are you sure? Yes. I also kind of love the song, I won't lie.
Where's that music coming from? What is happening?
Good afternoon, I've traveled from afar. A simple girl who wished upon a star. Inside this castle lies my fate. Perhaps so I'll even find a date. To my old life I sing au revoir.
This would be me. It slaps for no reason. Right. You want a metal detector? Here. Well, you have something there.
What is that?
Oh, that's just fossy.
What's a fossy?
A flamethrower.
Fossy is the name of my blowtorch. Friends shouldn't take things. That makes me a little bit nervous for you, Lil.
Okay, I've had about enough of you.
Okay. Now the truth thing will just part. I could try whip her, and we'll see what happens. I could be her. There we go. Okay. Remember, 3 stars run through a good score. 4 superb deduction. Result screens like this will be the guide towards a 3-star result, but 4 is up to you. Got 2, 3, 4 stars. Okay, can you? Oh yeah, I need to go to the dungeon room. Let's see what I'm wanting for. But yeah, I think the issue is her singing wasn't the only thing slaying. That's kind of the issue. Where's my mysterious note? Do I not have one?
Is this the right place?
It is! I mean,
Okay. Is it gonna be painted green? No. Oh, hi. It's all
three. Oh, you dared! Hello! Welcome to my lair of chaos!
It looks like a bedroom.
It is his damn bedroom.
It can be two things! I'm a minimalist.
So, this is the little guardsman we've been talking about. Wait, you are, right?
Yes.
I can't imagine why I wouldn't be.
Good news, little girl. You're going to be working the gate for the foreseeable future.
What?
What? That's not good news. Why me? I hardly have a grasp on what I'm doing, and I'm barely tall enough to see over the desk.
I see. Then you're free to go.
Keep it together, Mal.
No.
Listen, little girl. We have eyes and ears all over the city, but the gates have always been a blind spot for me.
The point is, the safety and security of the sprawl must be preserved and protected, and you might be positioned to help maintain the balance.
Okay.
Do you understand our meaning?
Yeah. Duh.
You want me to do favors for you? Use my position at the gate to let in the people that you want in, deny who you don't. Am I on the right track?
You're at the station!
What if I refuse? You can't make me do anything I don't want to do. I'm 12 years old.
Damn it, you've got us there. But how about we leave it up to chance? Guess which hand is holding the colored ball, and we'll forget about the whole thing. But if you guess it correctly, you agree to do our bidding no matter how nefarious or unreasonable.
Sound like a...
Do I even have a choice?
Yes. You choose which hand.
Not the brightest one, is she?
Left, right, or I could talk to Stryker or Ash. I'm gonna talk to Ash.
Malcolm is left-handed, I think. So I'd pick his left hand.
His right hand. Pick his right hand, you can't go wrong when you pick right.
He honestly said to the left. He honestly's not let me down yet. Oh, wait, I wanted the...
Oh, I'm sorry. That was the wrong choice. Oh, what you should have chosen was my foot.
Oh. Though I was losing either way.
But you said it would be in your hand.
And what is the foot if not the hand of the leg?
But...
You lost fair and square. I don't think I have.
Oh, and don't worry about your father. We're each quite capable at finding ways to keep him busy, making sure you have to cover for him.
But...
That concludes this briefing. We suggest you go back home, rest, and wake up tomorrow prepared to go to your new, mundane job, which you will work at for the foreseeable future.
It's called being an adult.
Keep an eye out for our directives in your daily guardsman writ.
Goodbye!
Why did you turn off the light? She obviously...
She wouldn't have known that if...
I should have brought another...
I'm 12 and I'm being blackmailed. I can't believe this is happening. Life comes at you fast. Dad, I'm currently being blackmailed by the government.
Boy, what a day. Hey, Arda, pour me a...
Make that too, Arda. Hey, wait a minute. You're too...
Can it at least be cold?
That depends.
Did better than a 2-star rating, I can tell you that. How?
The bidding of the 3 royal advisors.
Do you think it's normal that the big names and faces of this city are using us for their own personal and political gain?
After today, I don't know what's normal anymore.
I'm gonna go to bed. Goodbye.
I'm not ready for bed.
There's someone waiting for you in the back alley. Anyways, it's...
Oh, you got a hat! Oh my god, he has a hat! Wait, I didn't realize he would be in here. I don't care about you. You have a hat!
This hat... It is not as fun...
No, it doesn't look as fantastic as this one, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I let her in.
Aha! There she is, the Brit... I trust you refused entry to the envoy. If you did, I have the...
I let them in. Or do I say I kept them out? No, I let them in.
No, I totally let them in.
What? Why?
No, you thought you could bribe a guardian of the free peoples of the sprawl, which is a very serious offense.
Shake him down, give him a warning. Shake him down.
Please forgive me, incorruptible and honest steward of the kingdom.
I don't know, it's a pretty hefty scent.
All right. Take the...
What kind of gold are we...
I have here 20 pieces of gold. They are yours and with me, son of King Phineas.
Just the gold.
Oh. Yeah.
Here we go. I got the money. Excuse me, I need to go into this creepy dark alley. Which we can go in safely, because there's no one here trying to murder me.
Lil! Yeah.
Oh, you set up your shop! Well, this is fun. Isn't that the shield from the guy?
Welcome to Garby Bunches and Emporium of Wonder! You're my very first customer!
Don't have Karina.
I was actually inspired by watching you alternately help and hinder folks at the gate yesterday. And I thought, Garby, there must be an industry of enterprising individuals supporting the guards. And when I looked around, there wasn't. So I met a mage who's got a magic crystal hookup, and now I'm selling Guardsman Tool power-ups. If you've got the cash, I can sell you extra power crystals, both the good kind and the cheap, roll the dice and see. It's pricey, but the more crystals you... Finally, if you need cash, you can sell me anything you might have taken.
I can get rid of the bugle. I don't need that. Can I get rid of the gold bars? There's an additional crystal slot. Oh, I might need to just buy some crystals. You know? I can give him his things back. There you go, sir. Sorry. I also don't know if I need the head. I'm gonna keep the head and the two pictures for now. That was good. That cannot be safe. Well, would volunteers have shot that part of the screen? But I can't walk to that part of the screen, is the issue. Okay, let's go in and go to bed. Wait, that was the blood gold? Yeah, I sold the blood gold. It's just a little man in the back alley. Thought I'm giving it to the bank.
I think I've done everything I need. Quiet, you.
Alrighty.
I'm not ready.
Let's go over here.
I don't really have...
I don't have anywhere else to be. Okay, now I'm ready to head to bed.
I think I've... Quiet, you.
Okay, head to hay. What else was I meant to do with the blood gold? Just keep it? Gimme's McGoblin did a commendable job painting the dirty walls. Although humble, he is really quite skilled. He never let a drop hit the floor, and he did all the edges without using tape. Real high quality work. He brought much needed breath of life into the room where some people wait for execution. Gimme's went home with his hard-earned paycheck in one hand and a bouquet flower for his wife in the other. His six goblin children to bed swept his wife off her feet and took her to their room. The seventh child, Becky McGoblin, is due in the spring. Aww. Guys, Bugle envoy managed to make a favorable impression on the princess, the advisors, and the rest of the court. He lost them though when he tried to make bugle sounds with his mouth. That night, lying in bed in the chambers provided for visiting dignitaries, he felt ashamed for having not only sought to bribe all the guardsmen, but also having buckled under pressure. 12-year-old called him out for it. That night, his dream of the one day serving as an intelligent agent for the bedroom finally died. Capella Vodastico entered the sprawl and began his quest for the perfect hat. He ventured every store that sold headgear in the sprawls, Henry's hats, Linda's lids, Homer's haberdashery, and the chapeau shack. Mind your millinery? Hats, all caps, and even Yiddle's yarmulkle yurt. None of them had the time frame he was searching for. Rest assured, Vodastico will not relent until the top of his head is restored to its former glory. Myla. After relaying Peter Kingsman's princess, walked past the National Ballet of the Sprawls, rehearsing in the park. The Brownies were doing things completely wrong. Mary would enjoy that the teacher thing or two. Now the Sprawl Brownies are experts in first position and first degree murder. Since I was distracted, the Peter never got word of the princess's future message, but don't worry, they'll show up anyway. Night entry, the fake Sir Beverly took off his fake armor, got back on his fake horse, and went home to his real hut where he lived with his real mother and Walden in his very real depression. Chloe encountered a guard patrol outside the city gates and attempted to pickpocket them quietly, which didn't do successful in getting all the singing. In jail, it only took 5 minutes to be sent to solitary confinement. Level 3. Yeah, I don't mind the fact that...
It's news in the morning with me.
Okay, I don't care.
The chosen suitors for our beloved and newly available Princess Desdemona will be arriving today in the sprawl. Be on the lookout for royal carriages. Breaking news.
Also, everyone being like, you sold the blood thing, it was illegal. The three highest positions of the government are blackmailing me, a 12-year-old, to do this job. They don't care. For the charity branch, you need to... time how long it takes to run around the entire circumference of the sprawl.
You didn't tell me which team to bet on, but my chances can't be any worse than his usually are.
I've got to put a bet on. Bet the arrival of the Crown Prince Phineas of Petard and Petrore Carrigan of the Margave Empire. Don't let your guard down, but do not delay them unnecessarily. Today in the Goblin Ball Tri-Goblin Cup semi-final between our beloved small teams and Carolina the Bastards. There has been a BS report regarding a number of unusual transactions involving sports betting. Reminder of the guard force, safe has forbidden to participate in the green market sports betting. Guards are hearing talk of increased smuggling. Be vigilant, watch out for anything that could have a secret compartment. Trust no one. Deploy the truth sprayer if needed. Okay. Right. You can have one. You can have one. You can have one. I thought these were meant to carry over. Okay. We're gonna begin. Let's see who we've got today. Oh, it's him.
Yes, it is I, little one. Heir to the throne of Petrard, here before you in the flesh. Please, no need to bow or genuflect. No need to avert your eyes, no. For though I am a crowned prince of the realm, I am a humble.
I want to check the picture. Yeah, it looks very accurate.
You'll be glad to know that the opening ceremonies of our newest... Only 4 deaths, which is far fewer than the last. No matter, we look forward in Petrard. No sense crying over...
I'm glad things went well. Jeez, 4 dead? At an opening ceremony?
Yes, tragic. Avoidable, but still tragic. Luckily, it wasn't anyone important. A few unskilled laborers and 1 server. Could have been...
I think we just let him in. I don't see any issues, really.
I've heard tell that the barbaric warmonger Praetor Cargan is my chief rival for the hand of your fair princess. Can't even find decent competition these days. The Marvarg are a loathsome bunch of butchers, killing each other over the tiniest infractions. Bump into someone in the checkout line, trial
Aaron,
by combat.
Thank you so much for
accidentally
stuff.
Sneeze on a sacred heirloom, trial by combat. Worst vacation.
No doubt.
I wouldn't take the Marvog lightly if I were you. They are a proud warrior race who defend their honor with their lives. Some people might find that kind of sexy.
That is nothing compared to a handsome carriage ride around.
That sounds.
Indeed.
I'm just gonna let him in. I don't want to hold him up unnecessarily. And it's not my job to decide who gets married, Princess. I'll just let them both in and she can pick.
And with that, it is off to face the princess and destiny.
No, I'm not giving you a fiver.
Is it that you don't have the money?
Don't have it. I'm 12.
Not terribly surprising, lower class working type.
Okay, that's ridiculous.
Never mind, I'll find some.
Okay, sure. Win the crown, but you didn't spot him $5, which is your right. As if I'd spotted him the $5 that I got full. Okay, it's fine. The other woman wants $5, I'll help her.
Good day. I traveled up here with the convoy what was bringing Prince Phineas to the sprawl. Okay. I'm not staying long. Just need a place for tonight before I head back to Petrard.
Why do you have a choke at?
I was hired to come along with the convoy in case anything broke down on the way, in case repairs were needed on any of the equipment or transport. The prince doesn't exactly travel light. 3 carriages of wardrobe changes alone. To be honest, I don't get to the sprawl often. Too many mages around these parts for my liking.
You don't care for mages, eh?
Most Petrardians share the attitude that you should be able to explain the hows, whys, and wherefores of the world. Mages and their ilk don't subscribe to such thinking.
I don't not trust him. Like, he has a little tattoo here. Like, if my metal detector, this is just gonna ring, because he's, you know?
If I could have afforded to stay home, I would have. But they...
Was it a threat? A horse's head in your bed?
Nope, just a big heaping pile of money. The king and queen are desperate for the prince to secure the hand of Princess Desdemona. The future prosperity of Petrard depends on it. To be frank, the whole kingdom is flat broke. This is their only chance to marry rich.
I trust
her. I guess that explains the big deal everyone's making out of this whole let's marry the princess off thing. Shouldn't she have some kind of say in the matter?
Now that is something seriously worth considering.
I like him. You can go in. You're fine.
I thank you for this respite for the evening. I'm certainly glad I don't have to head all the way back to Petrard. By the way, do you know of a good inn nearby?
No better place than the Twisted Sisters Tavern. No-
My kind of establishment.
I get to see him later. That's exciting. Lots of things falling apart in the sprawl, and your pleasant report may lead to him fixing a thing or two for you. Yeah. See, I knew we trusted him.
Sprinkles!
Awkward of black blood folk, porch shed weeping and moaning. Oh no.
Oh, boo hoo hoo.
What in the Adams family's going on?
Weep, weep, weep.
Hello?
We are returning from the funeral services for Sprinkles.
Oh, no!
The service was held in the Duchy of Scarborough, but the, remains...
Sprinkles loved visiting her friends at St. Euphigenia's.
I'm so sorry.
We do not have a pet cemetery suitable for such...
What exactly is a duchy?
It is a parcel of land under the purview of a duke or duchess. Scarborough is the duchy controlled by Her Grace, the Duchess of Scarborough.
Present?
And it is a far nicer duchy than some. For instance, the Duchy of Caladar.
Caladar! What a dump!
I'm gonna X-ray. I would like to see what's in the box, please. That's not a cat. No, it is. It's just ash.
What's this, then?
That's dust.
Of course it is. There's a corpse in there, after all.
That was just...
No, pixie dust. It's an illegal narcotic used by layabouts and no-goodniks. What on earth is it doing inside Sprinkles?
Old people with the drugs.
I confess, I've been holding this inside for too long. I was approached by a weird guy who tricked me into smuggling illegal pixie dust into the sprawl for him. He was holding the ball in his foot. Who does that? I plead guilty, Your Honor, on the grounds of I did it.
It's Malcolm.
I'm not a judge, you know.
Oh.
But I'll leave it to the courts to deal with this. The rest of you, pack up your dead cat and be on your way.
Okay. I just let the other ones in, that's fine.
All right, have fun burying your cat.
We shall.
Sprinkles will be so happy at St. Euphigenia's. I just know it. Thank you, my dear. Sprinkles thanks you.
Oh, good. And that's how you X-ray your way to success.
Hey. You did a sting. You followed drug smuggling, bringing narcotic pixie dust to the spawn side. What a weird day. Good job. Yes, they're sus. They're all sus. Hi.
Phew, I made it. Listen, I gotta get in there.
The whole team came through a while ago, and the game is about to start. We all good?
And you are?
You're kidding, right? Come on, I'm Saruna Goodfoot, the Star Troll Goblin Ball player for the Kaladar Lightning.
Kaladar Lightning.
I don't have time for games right now. I gotta get to this.
Goblin between our beloved Sprawl Brawlers and the Kaladar Light. I think I call Ash. I think she's gonna do a deliver in.
Oh yes, Saruna. I heard she was running late for the game. Something about an unfortunate detour at the last minute. Such a shame. Because if a team doesn't win today, then I won't have to owe the mayor of Kaladar 5 barrels of fine Sprawlian mulled wine. Do me a favor. Keep her busy until the game is over, will you?
Come on, the big goblin ball game starts in 30 minutes! My stupid person.
Is it really your personal driver's fault, or is it that you have a hard time dealing with pressure?
You sound just like my psychiatrist.
Personal driver? Psychiatrist? Is there anything you don't have?
I don't have time to talk to you all day.
Too bad you're gonna have to. I'm gonna eat. Can I not eat it? No, I can't. I just blow up Parker.
Can we move this along? They're such a horrible team. I bet we could win even without my...
What lucky second sweatband?
This lucky second...
I'm gonna compass. That's mine.
Hey, you can't take that! I needed to win the big game today!
I have to take it. It's evidence.
Evidence? What are you talking about?
Evidence that you don't need some lousy sweatband to win a game. You just need to believe in yourself.
Huh. I never thought about it like that before.
Belongs bunch of people. It's fire.
Oh god.
Okay, so I've got Ash telling me not to let them in, or I can let them in. Run a poll for me. Let's run a poll. Because if I deny it, then it's, like, good for me for the bad people? Okay, more people are saying let them in. I'm gonna have to let them in.
Thanks. Now to wipe the floor with those lousy Sprawl Brawlers. When you hear the crowd cheering my name, you'll know it's for me.
Well, duh.
You mentioned the star player of the color with our lucky sweatband band. Taking sweatband. It's anyone's game. Okay, see, like, I've done it where it's like, I've let her in. I took the sweatband and she needs to win. So it's now up to fate. You're
greetings!
Not.
I am Praetor Kargan of the Marvog Empire. I believe you met my envoy, the angry warrior with... She would have come by this gate to announce...
You're just no.
Why do you pester me with questions? I am a very important royal figure.
Just a few more routine procedures. You understand.
Please hurry. I do not like to be kept waiting.
Let's bill whip it.
I do not fear the dainty crack of a whip. If I was afraid of whips, I'd have never made it in the tango.
You mean ballet, right?
Of course. Don't you think I remember what form of dance almost killed me?
Your envoy said you had a message for the princess. What was that message again?
My message? Oh, it's Icky Bok Choi Flanagan Mok Tok. It means together we shall be married.
That's not beautiful. The same person.
Thank you. Quap Lorm.
How long did it take you to learn a second language?
Not that long. It wasn't hard to learn Marvagian. I mean, this language we're currently speaking.
Yeah, literally, it's not hard. I'm gonna click deny here, basically.
But I am the Prattle!
What on earth are you doing? Since when are you exercising independent thought? I don't care what your opinion of them is. If they're the real Praetor Kargan...
It's all denying you, because you're not the real one.
You've made a powerful enemy today, little girl. You'll soon...
You saw through the fake predator routine from Elway. Who do you think you are? Someone you can't see through the old fake predator routine? Amateur. There she is.
Little warrior, I am weary after a long journey, and I am not used to being made to wait in a lineup. Let me pass on my way. I must rest before I meet your princess in order to win her hand and bring honor to my people.
This seems more legit. This may seem like a strange request, but would you mind saying your famous battle cry for me?
You mean Kapla!
That's the one.
I would hope that my stunning war cry is sufficient to being granted entry.
It is. Pretty strong lady. Here you go. You have no questions, Aniko.
And thus I truly begin my quest to marry Princess Desdemona and bring a generation of prosperity to the Marvog Empire.
Let's go, lesbians!
You,
let's go.
Little warrior, will have a footnote in history for this Yay. Encounter. For victory. For Marvog. Kapla!
Yeah. Bye. For imposter, it was very clear. Exemplary job granted an immediate entry. I'm going to accuse you of unnecessarily delaying anyone. He did unnecessarily delay the game. I did get Molotoved! Three and a half again. Barbie's shop, Gumball Stadium. Oh, I need to go and put a bet on, don't I? A different hat on.
Hello! Thank you for coming to my booth today. I'm here taking a poll on
what's wrong with the Goblin Ball Stadium?
It's a little on the nose. The owners want a little more puzzle.
Actually, I've really...
Great!
Exciting.
Perfect! And...
It's a Colosseum.
Excellent! And... Okay, that is soup.
That's him. Yeah.
This hat!
Yeah, that's fair. Why do you look so creepy?
Concessions! Come and get them! We got it all! T-shirts, hat...
Did you say illegal?
I sure did.
I'm 12.
Hey, it's illegal anyways. What's the difference?
I can't be any worse at this than my...
Here are the teams at play, kiddo.
The Kangar Lightning Sprawl Brawlers. Kangar Lightning got their lead, but I did take their headband. So who do I vote for? Do I go for the Sprawl Brawlers or do I go for Kaladar Lightning? I think the Sprawl Brawlers. Home time.
The home team hasn't been doing too well at home lately. A lot of people are still angry at him after that game with the foul and the points got reinstated. They're more of an away team, but they're a shoo-in to win today. If the other team didn't have that ringer Saruna Goodfoot playing for them. You sure you want to... How much you looking at...
There. Yeah.
All right, kid.
Let's watch some gobble.
I need the Sprawl Brawlers to win it.
After one of the most chaotic third quarters I've ever seen, complete with the rare capture of the golden mongoose, this is still anybody's game. But look, Kaladar star player Saruna Goodfoot has taken possession of the wagon wheel.
No.
My producer is just telling me she isn't wearing her signature lucky second sweatband. Well, that's weird. She's running, and she hurls the wagon wheel, and it misses the flaming gates by a long shot. What an upset. That's the game, folks. A stunning victory for the hometown heroes. What a great day of Goblin Ball.
Yeah.
Lucky guess, kid. Come back next time for all your...
Oh my god, this was great. Yes, I made 60. I should take up gambling in real life. You know what? Let me go to Garby's shop now, because I'm going to try and sell him the sweatband. And be like, hey, I was told this would sell for money to the right person. Are you the right person? Garby!
Well, if it is... They almost cleaned me out!
Congratulations.
Gee, Garby. Thanks!
$40? Yeah. I'm gonna buy another couple, I think. I also don't know if I need those photos anymore. I'm gonna keep them until, like, the... Until she is married to someone. Until the princess has decided which of those two she wants. I'm keeping them. Because my other thought is, like, whoever she marries, it'll be like, oh, look, I've got a selfie of the new queen's husband or wife, you know? Hello, little dwarven man.
If it isn't my little gate guard friend, of all the taverns and all the towns and all the world.
Yeah, yeah. Hello again, Mr. Dwarf.
This jukebox doesn't work.
Yeah, it's been broken for ages.
Looks like the cables have been chewed right through.
Yeah.
Must have been the rats.
Yuck. Rats?
I mean, natural erosion.
Natural erosion, my left foot. Anyway, I can...
That would be wonderful.
For a price.
Crap.
Okay.
Hmm.
All right, it's a deal.
Beauty. See, that's the wonderful thing about knowing how to fix things. Never goes out of style. Not like...
How long is this gonna take?
Listen, lady.
Never once clicked in this thing.
There you go. That's...
Thanks, Mr. Dwarf.
Don't mention it. Now.
Now that's better.
Hey. Oh, guardsman themed. He's in Christmas football. Well, he mentioned. You failed me, you're dead. Hey, what's that one play? You can just change the background music. It's a goblin.
I did it. I quit my job as lackey to that awful man. And when I mentioned it to someone at the bus stop, they gave me a sock. And I have no idea why. Just one sock, not even the pair. What am I supposed to do with one sock? Oh, I made a terrible mistake.
Good reference.
I think I've done it.
Get the hay. He's free now. Upon entering the sprawl, Profanus presented himself at the court with the princess, but because you didn't lend him a fiver, he was not able to double it in a game of beer pong at the Bachelor's Club, which he could have then tripled, participating in a league turns arm wrestling. Maybe it's for the best. Dwarven Tinker left his interaction with Lil the Guardsman with a spring in his step. The connection he made in time of increasing intolerance towards non-humans made him think that perhaps the rumor of bigotry in the sprawl has been greatly exaggerated. Unfortunately, just before heading to his bed at the room at the inn, he took in the night air and chanced upon a group of young men leaving the social club for the Sons of Nobles club pit. They were able to overpower him and stuff him into a garbage can. He spent the next morning without his recent discovered faith in humanity. Duchess of Scarborough, her valet, and the entourage made it to St. Eugenia's just in time for the solemn event of Sprinkle's funeral. There was not a dry eye in the house, nor a dry crotch when it came to cats and attendants who commemorated the event by cleaning themselves through the Duchess' moving eulogy. The smuggler was apprehended and promptly sent to the dungeon. Fortunately, he escaped sometime between midnight and 2 a.m. with the help of his mysterious contact on the outside. His office happened to be just down the hall from that particular cell. Runa Goldfoot. After the Goblin Games, Runa had to face the scorn of her disappointing coach and teammates, but only for about 30 seconds, as she was the only troll on the team and dwarfed the other players. They were all rightly terrified of her. She had to participate the next day, inspired to live up to her personal best, even without her second lucky headband. Ah, cute. Vic Pirator, that you very wisely turned away, took their stick on the road and was eventually picked up by the Margrave authorities for impersonating beloved Pirator. He was later sentenced to perform in the next ballet, lovingly called the Nutcracker. Pirator Cargan, because she was admitted to get without any inherent hindrance whatsoever, Pirator had a few extra minutes on her hands where she needed to present herself at the palace. She had just the best time. She met a good dog as she patted. She kicked a football around with a couple of only slightly filthy rug muffins on the Westphalian green. She made an extremely clean cut as she dismembered the left arm of a mugger who attempted to take the coin purse. All in all, one of the most relaxing afternoons in recent memory for her, and she was refreshed and rejuvenated by the time it took her to court, where she dazzled those in attendance. Yeah! Get it, girl! Love that. And that's where I think I'm going to call it for this evening. I'm going to quit game. That was a lot of fun. I'm definitely going to play that again. I definitely want to see what else happens. That was a lot of fun, though. I am going to send you all over now to Soup for Eloise while I begin dismantling my office. Fun. But thank you all for coming and hanging out. We'll definitely play that again some other time. I will see you all tomorrow, I think around 7 p.m. for some more Enshrouded with Whip Sausage and Shelby. And I will see you all then. Bye!